Hello, Mayors. This is Diana presenting to you the second edition of the Archaeological Expeditions. There are a few changes, and I hope you will find the new edition easier to understand than the first one. I will not enter into all the details. You can still find the document from last time on our help center if you need to refresh your memory. The most important change in this edition is that there are no more keys for opening the sealed cave. So no more depending on the key falling or not when removing obstacles on the expedition location. Instead, you will concentrate on completing tasks. For unlocking the sealed cave, you will also have to complete a task instead of opening with a key. But first of all, let's take a look inside the archaeological museum. You will notice a new exhibition is now available. You can now work on the Ancient Rome exhibition. And just like last time, you will have to get as many tiny shards as possible to restore artifacts. And the more artifacts you have, the better your exhibition profit will be. And the overall museum profit depends on how many exhibitions you have on display and how many artifacts in them. The previous exhibition is not gone. You can still find it if you use the blue arrows on the expositions tab. See, Ancient Egypt. Ancient Rome. Or from the Rooms tab, you can find both of them. And if you have more than one room in the museum, you will be able to display both of them at the same time for a larger profit. If you have participated in the previous expedition but did not manage to complete the Ancient Egypt collection, you can continue working on it now if you wish to do so. So with that being said, let's embark on the new adventure. You will notice from the very beginning that we have a new object on the map. Beside the field kitchen that you will have to restore at every location and you will be able to craft energy cans there. You also have now the mobile stand. And here you can complete tasks for getting extra energy, but also some needed items. I think that it is a big advantage that you have this mobile stand right from the very beginning. It will provide us with quite a boost. If you remember last time, we had some huts and some houses placed on the expedition location, and you could restore them and then get energy from them. So now you have the mobile stand right at the beginning, and I think this is quite good. Other ways of getting purple energy, let's go over them once again. Of course, you can claim 100 units every 12 hours. You can open chests on the temporary expedition location. And if you played last time, you know that you can get some extra energy from the club. If you are in a club and your club is playing the expedition on a daily basis quite actively, the expedition energy expenditure is accumulating, and once you reach a certain milestone, you will get an energy delivery from the club. There are also some other advantages if you are in a club. For every activity undertaken on the expedition map, you will get excavation points that you will be able to trade in for useful things like candies, artifact fragments, super bucks, marathon cards, more purple energy, and so on. And this time the main club reward is the Jupiter statue. Last time we had the Egyptian sanctuary. It will also drop glass bubbles in the future. And of course, there are also the club ratings, the club tournament, as usual, with its own set of rewards. Besides the club offers, you also have an individual promotion. This time it is the chariot workshop. And you will have to collect 2,500 valuable finds in the given time and get this reward. You can get valuable finds by simply removing obstacles on the expedition map. The chariot workshop is also a glass bubble dropper in the future, so if you can get it That would be absolutely fantastic. And now I would like to advance a little and show you how to open the sealed cave this time. Okay, so I will progress further on the map and be right back in a few seconds. Friends, I have clicked the map more and now I'm ready to show you how to open the sealed cave this time. I have followed closely the quest situated on the left side of the screen, and I have restored here, for example, some map objects for obtaining tiny shards, like this tomb over here, and the ancient sanctuary over here. And behind the last gate, I have found the sealed cave. As I mentioned, there is no key this time. It is not necessary to find a key and unlock the sealed cave with a key. You will have to complete a task for it. I have already gathered the items for opening the sealed cave, and I will go ahead and unlock it. As you can see, the cave is already opened and I got the last tiny shards in this location. And now I have the possibility to move on. Just like last time, I won't be able to return here. So please make sure to collect everything you want to collect from this location before moving on. That is, I guess, all for now. I hope you will find the new format easier to understand and easier to navigate. And enjoy the mini expeditions. I hope you will get a lot of tiny shards and build a beautiful collection in your museum. Stay safe and enjoy Super City. For all the newest Super City information and contests, please bookmark our Facebook page and our help center, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button on our YouTube channel. I would really appreciate it if you do so. Thank you.